I know your jacket. Thank you guys for coming. Are we ready?
Miss Murray, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y syzygy.
We have a winner!
Putnam County Spelling Bee. My parents keep on telling me, just being here is winning. Although I know it isn't so.
But it's a very nice, very, very nice, very, very nice, very nice beginning. Our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino. Let's give him a hand.
Announce my name.
Leave Pony Bear.
I'm gonna try to keep from shaking.
At last, his shaking will not pass.
But it's a very big, very fraught, simple, but it's not. It's a very big undertaking. Returning after last season's tragic setback, Wilhelmina Murphy.
It's pronounced Murphy. There's an accent.
Gil.
Oh, I'm not sure who this girl is.
Marcy Park. Transfer.
Winner's destination, Washington, D.C.
Live on TV in a fancy hotel, where they treat you well, all because you love to spell.
At the 25th annual, we memorized the manual
about how to spell these words, words that require thought. People think we're automatons, but that is exactly what we're not.
We hear the word,
we breathe,
we breathe.
Unlike idiots, we idiots.
To idiot is to form an image or idea. To think.
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee,
we feel no animosity.
And yet our heads are spinning.
We are the slightest bit bizarre.
We concentrate on winning. At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, we speak so damn convincingly.
They're nervous, but they're grinning.
It seems we're living out a dream.
Which is very nice, very nice.
Very, very, very nice, very nice, very, 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 very nice, very nice.
time to please ask you all to turn off your cell phones and put away any other distracting devices. Oh, and no cameras, sorry, no photos at the bee. Now I'd like to take this time to please acknowledge our spellers. If I call your name, please escort yourself to the stage right or stage left benches. I'm missing Jill Lutzig, Michael Applebaum, to compete in the National Spelling Bee. And for this year's silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrists, have offered today's winner a $200 savings bond towards his or her future education.
Oh, that's very cool.
But to get here, each speller had to either win or place in their own district bee. So each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hello. I'm Rona Lisa Peretti, and I'm pleased to be back for my ninth consecutive year here as your host. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Spriggs, has been contact traced for the fourth time this year, so please join me in welcoming Vice Principal Douglas Panch from Lake Hemingway Dos Passos Junior High. Returning to us after a five-year hiatus. So thank you, Douglas, for stepping in on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona. And I would like to say, as to the incident 5 years ago, I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a change of diet can do for a man. Thank you.
Wonderful.
Oh, and may I add, Ms. Peretti here is not only one of Putnam County's top realtors, she's also a former spelling champion herself.
Third annual.
Syzygy.
When the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
And now for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by our Comfort Counselor, Ms. Michelle M. Mahoney.
Ms. Michelle M. Mahoney is doing her community service work with us here today.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Spellers, be seated. Thank you, Michelle.
And now for the official spelling bee rules.
A speller
may ask questions
about the word's pronunciation or definition.
Definition.
Used in a sentence.
In a sentence.
And its language of origin.
Language of origin.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over,
but the sequence of letters already spoken may not be changed.
If you
misspell a word,
you will ring. Comfort Counselor
Michelle Mahoney.
We'll escort you upstairs.
Is that understood, spellers?
Yes.
Before anyone is disqualified and before proceedings turn snide and contestants turn nasty, I soberly confide. First catastrophe. Oh, I love what I see. Kids acting innocently. That's my favorite moment of the bee. Rona's face.
let the spelling begin with Miss Schwarten Grubenier.
Miss Logan Schwarten Grubenier is head of the Gay Straight Alliance at her elementary school.
Strabismus.
Strabismus. May I please have the definition of that word?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other because of an imbalance of the muscles of the eyeball.
And use in a sentence, please.
In the schoolyard, Billy protested that he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said, where the bullies beat him harder.
Strabismus.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way to say the word before speaking it aloud.
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct, Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear was second runner-up in the Putnam Basin District.
Brooke, will you tell Leaf he has a phone call, please?
Leaf!
Phone!
That's a goat! Leaf speaking. I can't believe it. I'm gonna represent the basin and the bee. No way! Mom, Dad, Miracle, Brooke, Pontoon, Raisin, Lansky! Paul, that's how I'm gonna believe this.
What's up, Leaf?
I'm gonna represent the basin and the bee.
No, honey, you came in third, sweetheart.
Yeah, I know, but they just called, and they said the person who got in first has to go to a bar mitzvah, and the person who got in second has to attend the bar mitzvah, so they want me to do it.
You understand that all the other kids will have already won their county bees.
Yeah, I know, but...
Capybara!
What?
Your word is capybara.
Is that a word?
That's a word, yes.
What does it mean?
A tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
What else can I ask?
You can ask for the word's language of origin or to have...
Oh, can I use it in a sentence?
Yes. Don't look now, Pedro, but I think that tailless, largely aquatic, 4.5-foot rodent swimming next to you may be a capybara.
Wow, that didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word, Mr. Coney Bear?
Oh, no, but it was fun coming here. My family's here, which is correct. Capybara! C-A-P-B-Y-B-A-R-A! Capybara.
That is correct, Miss Ostrovsky.
That's crazy, I just said the first letter that came to my head. I can't believe that's right.
Miss Ostrovsky, Ostrovsky came in second in her school's Halloween contest. I was roadkill.
Philanthropy.
Can I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am. Can you not sit in that seat? I saved a chair for my dad in the first row on the aisle. And it may take him a while, but when he gets here, that's his chair. Because my mother's in an ashram in India, I saved a chair for her too. But it's merely symbolic, as daily she cleanses herself in the Ganges. And I live in a house with an oversized dictionary that I read as a girl on the toilet.
Philanthropy.
Is that from the Latin root bo meaning ox and the Greek root anthro meaning man?
Sure.
I love my dictionary and I love the indented border. Every word's in alphabetical order. Ergo, lost things always can be found. And I wrap my head around the fact that in the book is the entire language of our species, which is a favorite term of Nietzsche's, who's the great grandmother of Christina Ricci's. Yes, I joke with the words in the dictionary. Friends that I'll have forever. More than the friends I have made in school.
She's such a lovely girl. What a lovely little
mistake and be disqualified. Philanthropy. Being a
Fresno!
Miss Benedetto has an irrational fear of Cat in the Hat.
A poop.
Ooh, may I have a definition?
Toward the back to move astern on a boat.
Could you use it in a sentence, please?
Guido, the seasick Italian sailor, said, "Excuse me, boys, but I'm gonna go a poop."
That was helpful. A P O O P.
That is correct.
Lightyear from Toy Story.
Lysergic acid diphenylamide.
My definition, please?
A hallucinogenic drug that produces profound changes in perception and mood.
Can you use that in a sentence?
Rita took too much lysergic acid diphenylamide and thought she was full of rabbits.
L-E-S-T-H-E-R-I-C D O L P H T I M A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O P Q
R S T U V W X Y. I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
She's the only one I've ever seen use it. She takes her foot and spells it out on the floor to get a visual, and then speaks it out loud. Incredible.
Lugubrious. L-U-G-U. Lugu. B-R-I-O-U-S. Lugubrious.
That is correct.
I know.
Mr. Applebaum.
Donald is a Russian spy.
Chair. That's so easy.
Chair.
Only the speller delight is allowed to speak.
May I have the definition, please?
A four-legged seating implement which you sit in.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
You just got out of a chair.
C-H-A-I-R. Chair.
That is correct. Miss Park.
Miss Marcy Park is new to our county, having placed 9th in nationals last year as a representative of Virginia.
Ooh,
nationals!
Beautiful country. Miss Park, your word is phylactery.
Phylactery, am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Thank you. May I have the definition, please?
Either of two small square leather boxes containing religious text traditionally worn in the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have a sentence, please?
Billy, put down that phylactery! We're Episcopalian!
Thank you. Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery.
That is correct.
Slam dunk from Park.
Hey, Mosey, you were at our nationals, right? Remember me?
I only remember the top 10.
Charlito Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22-mile-an-hour screwball.
Full of skepsis. Wait a second. Didn't the guy who believed Ronald McDonald was a Russian spy got chair? Yes, and you got full of skepsis. But are those rated at the same level of difficulty? They're both level one words, yes. Full of skepsis. Yes. Can you also pronounce that full of skepsis? You can. It would be wrong. Full of skepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Full of skepsis. That is correct.
He rallies and nails it. That's what it means to be a champion.
Miss Lustig.
Miss Lustig always claims it was their imaginary friend who went to bed.
Cow.
meeting.
Only the spiller at the mic is allowed to speak.
Language of origin?
Everywhere.
Definition, please.
It means a cow.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Please spell cow.
C-O-W.
That is correct. Sally's mother told her it was her cystitis that made her special.
Cystitis? I
think I studied
this one with my dad. Segway!
S-A-Q-E! Good, siphon!
S-A-K-H-O-N!
Good, cystitis!
F!
No, think.
C!
Good.
I!
No, Logan, are you concentrating?
Yes.
Maybe it's time for a break.
We're in the middle of a word here, Dan.
You know she had that spell on her blood sugar's low, Carl.
The B could last hours. We have to build up her stamina.
Don't you talk to me about stamina, Carl.
Daddy conference, now.
No, Dad. Can we get this one first, please?
We need a spelling, please, Logan.
Cystitis. C-Y-S-T-I-T-I-S. Cystitis.
That is correct, Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear makes his own clothes.
A coochie.
A what?
Listen to the whole word, please. A coochie.
Spelling bee, what does it mean?
A South American rodent of the genus Myoprocta resembling an agouti.
Funny how I keep getting South American rodents.
Hilarious.
Well, to be honest, I've never heard this word before, and I have no clue what it means. So I'm,
Would you like to forfeit your turn?
Why don't you just give it your best shot, Mr. Gummy Bear?
I'm not that smart. My siblings have been telling me that for years. That I'm not smart. We're schooled at home, they see who's bright. It breaks my heart. I'm not that smart. Guess what? You wanna know what? I have a gentle personality, which you'll all agree is at the motto of my more aggressive family. Everyone keeps swatting.
Dumb kid!
Everyone keeps yelling.
Dumb kid!
How could a flea such as me think he'd be good at spelling? I like my hair. Really, it is pleasant to the touch. I toss my hair a bit too much. It doesn't move, it simply sits. I make a part, I'm not that smart. La la.
Flagellate! F-L-A-G-E-L! L-A-T-E, flagellate!
Oh, incorrect.
Is that your sister?
Yeah, that's Marigold!
Miss Benedetto!
Miss Benedetto got bitten by dolphins while on her Key West trip.
Tatterjean!
Can you put it in a sentence for me?
The neap tide is upon us. The Leviathan appears. Catcher jeans.
Yeah. And, what does it mean?
Unknown. A Nantucket whaling term.
Catcher jeans. C-A-T-A-J-E-N-E-S. Oh.
That is correct. Hmm. Oh, look, Miss Benedetto! We have another word for you. Xerothalmiology.
Oh, this is an easy one. Can you put it in a sentence for me?
Stoner Billy's gullible mother always buys a xerothalmiology excuse.
Thank you. And can I have a definition?
Abnormal redness of the eyes or dilation of the pupils caused by a deficiency of vitamin A.
Can you say the word again?
Xerothalmiology.
Z E.
I'm sorry, there's a silent X.
Thank you.
Goodbye!
Last year, but had to be eliminated for health-related reasons.
Were there peanuts in the brownies? They said there wouldn't be no peanuts in the brownies!
I'm glad to see her back and spelling so well.
Hassenpfeffer.
Yes, of course. Hassenpfeffer, a highly seasoned rabbit stew often served with sour cream.
Rabbit stew, that's correct.
My old friend. One moment, please.
She's going for the foot.
Magic foot, take me to the final round. Magic foot, barely lifted off the ground. Magic foot, do it without making a sound. Better way to spell. Okay, let's see what we got here, foot. H-A-S-E-N. Hassen. A P-F-E-F-F. P-F-F. E-R. Let's go. Magic foot. If you're not specific, magic foot. It's terrific when you make all word with your foot. Magic foot.
Magic foot. Magic foot. Magic foot. Magic foot.
Magic foot. Don't go kaput. Foot.
Magic foot. Better way to
magic foot.
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 paper rolls last month.
Mr. Applebaum, your word is dangy.
Can you repeat the word?
Dangy.
Can I have the definition, please?
A disease transmitted by mosquitoes that causes headache, severe joint pain, rash, and severe diarrhea.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
When the pediatrician asked Billy to describe the symptoms of his dengue, he said, "It's like a race out of my tushy, and everyone won."
Dengue. D-A-N-G-H-Y. Dengue.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
The trouble, your shirt.
Goodbye. You were good, but not good enough. So please don't ask why. Simply say goodbye.
Miss Park.
Miss Park skipped fourth and fifth grades. She's on track to becoming the youngest high school freshman in parochial school history.
Miss Park, your word is Kamikam.
Kamikam, a lieutenant or deputy in the Ottoman Empire, a rare exception to the QU rule from the Turkish, Q-A-I-M-A-Q-A-M, Kamikam.
That's remarkable.
Incorrect.
Miss Park is all business.
I am not.
Mr. Tolentino.
Mary Moore, and a pony bear. That's a real lovely
Chip.
Sweater you have on Mary
Chip. Moore. Chip!
Sorry, did they like throw the spell?
Yes!
A rare break in concentration for Mr. Tolentino.
Can you maybe skip me now and ask me two in a row later?
Why would you want to do that?
I'd rather not say.
You can either take your turn now or forfeit.
Take my turn.
Another excellent decision by the incumbent.
Tit-top.
What?
Your word is tit-top.
Definition, please.
It means lively movement or behavior, or to move restlessly. It refers to the sound of horses' hooves. Tit-top, tit-top, tit-top.
Tit-up. T-I-T-U. Oh, wait, two T's backing up. You heard both, right? T-I-T-T-U-P. Tit-up.
I'm sorry. The correct spelling is T-I-T-T-U-P. Tit-top.
Exactly what I said!
But first you said T-I-T-U, away, backing up two T's.
I wasn't sure if you heard both T's. I obviously know how to spell it!
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequence of the letters already spoken may not be changed.
I can't get a word that I got right!
Life is random and unfair. Life is pandemonium.
I said two T's! I won last year!
That's the reason we despair. Life is pandemonium.
You can't comfort these damn kids. They don't yet know that the good don't always win. There's nothing you could say to cheer them up when they lose. I want to tell them disappointment doesn't last. But from what I've seen, disappointment lasts like hell. I want to tell them words don't matter. But from what I've seen, words can get you killed. I just want to beat them up a little so they understand that pain has degrees and this is nothing. This is nothing, you little freaks. But that would violate my parole, so I do what I can. I give them a thumbs up and a juice box. I'm here to give comfort.
Mr. Peretti, do I have one more chance? Please.
Let's go, kid.
Goodbye.
Little Lord, that's what spell about spelling bees. I am floored by how last year's big cheese becomes this year's disaster and exits with new. Jamboree, and winners lose surprisingly. Oh, I love what I see. I see hope and possibility. When the favorite loses, one, two, three.
Ms. Lustig.
Ms. Lustig always enjoys wearing pajama pants on Zoom calls.
Knickknick.
What?
Knickknick.
Definition, please.
A tobacco of dried leaves and bark smoked by Indians of the Great Lakes region.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Puffing on his knickknick, Chief Little Feather took in the quiet serenity of the valley and said, "Here, here we will put the craps table."
Knickknick. K-I-N. A-F-B-T-C-K, what? Knickknick.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
Please.
My friend, you will be missed. But now go with dignity. This ends, but first on our list, you should go with pride. You've been the best looking gal we've had all day. You're a real smart gal as well. Now go home and spell. Give your squeeze some affection. Come on, make a connection. Spell with patience and care. That gal is my prayer.
Goodbye.
Hand sanitizer, please.
I got you, G. Sir, I got you.
I can't believe they're making me do this. This is crap. I can't believe I'm a boss. You know what? Screw it!
It is tradition. Got the person eliminated from the competition. It's very important reason. Especially the alpha male, who's so good he's at our COVID sale. Anyone for face masks, anyone for sanitizer, anyone for anything that isn't dated. How could I have been eliminated? You wanna know how, you wanna know how, you wanna know why. My unfortunate erection is destroying my perfection. It is my recollection that everything I once did, I did perfectly. Last year's champ defeated because of Marigold Coney Bear. Because something and not a thing between us. I don't blame my brain, but I do blame my penis. My unfortunate protuberance seems to have its own exuberance. Anyone for face masks? Pretty inappropriate. Anyone for sanitizer? Expensive. Anyone for buying the shit that I'm selling? Because my skippy has ruined my spelling. Erection! Erection! My unfortunate erection! Whoa! It's ruining my life, it's ruining my world, it's ruining my, ruining my life. My life! Adulthood brings its own peculiar rejection. Which is why I'm selling this PTA collection. It will ruin your complexion.
boss. You're the biggest loser here.
Oh, yeah? Well, that is a common misperception!
Sorry about that. Wilhelmina, right?
I'm Olive.
I know your name. Look, I do not need pity from a person named after a vegetable.
It's a fruit.
Well, it's a disgusting fruit, and I can't keep them down.
Oh.
No, I guess it's okay for a name, though.
Well, did you know that if you switch the first two vowels of Olive, it becomes I love?
Did you know that if you switch the first two vowels in Wilhelmina, it becomes Wilhelmina?
Well, yeah, but you could switch the next two.
Then it's Wilhelmina.
Are these really the kinds of things you think about?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm more of a science girl myself.
You're also a really great scholar.
Yeah? Thanks! Olive. I love. Ugh, that's so stupid.
Ladies and gentlemen, our final spellers, let's give them a hand. We have homeschooled from the Basin Leaf Coney Bear.
Mom, I made it to the finals!
From Our Lady of Intermittent Sorrows, Miss Marcy Park.
I am not all business.
From Cold Spring Country Day, Miss Wilhelmina Barfee.
Oh.
From Garrison Elementary, Miss Olive Ostrovsky.
Oh, Miss Bernie, my dad.
And from the Magna Magnet Grammar School, Miss Logan Schwartz and Grubinier.
I would like to take a moment to thank my two dads, Daniel Schwartz and Carl Grubinier, for being so supportive of me in all my endeavors. Thank you, Dad.
Which is why we discipline. God hates losers. Because losers do not know how to win.
Thank you, Marcy. I hope
you can love me, America. I'm gunning for first prize. Here's why you should love me, America. Money that cannot overemphasize. I make myself poor, you see. Being what my dad told about me. But what about me, Dad? What about me? That's Christ! What about me?
Practice your breathing, Logan.
No, I practice yoga. I don't breathe. I try not to disappoint, but still I disappoint the dad too. My friends, Mom. Kids are mean. Kids are tough. My so-called friends hold their eyes. They're incredibly petty. Because my dads are my dads and I'm friend enough already.
Woe is me. Woe is me.
Which is why I gotta win this spelling bee.
Take another picture for her BMI.
Dad!
Don't call her that, Carl.
Sorry, her birth mother.
I need to think it.
We'll be very proud to see you spell.
Tornadoes!
Every now and then she writes a card. Like Ben Man, she says, are hard. She would like to meet me when I grow and I burst like a comet. But I'm so stressed by my stress, I just wander up and vomit.
Woe is me, woe is me.
Which is why I gotta win spelling.
Be smart, be cool, be loud, be remarkably adroit in social situations. Be smart, be cool, be smart, be cool, be smart, be cool, be smart, be cool.
Which is why I gotta win
this
Miss Schwartz and Grubinier, tilapia.
Tilapia, T-I-L-A-P-I-A.
That's correct, Mr. Cody Bear Veneer.
Veneer B-M-E-R.
That's correct, Mr. Tusky Swabbit.
S-Y-L-L-A.
Chinchilla.
Hear the bell? That, to me, is not an exciting sound. That little ding, to me it brings a plaintive air. I always thought that life was fair. At least I never felt a smidgen of despair. They say a bell can break your heart, but just not mine. Since I opine, I think, no, I know I'm smart. Apertures, please.
Sheila says my hobbies are weird, but my real mom Joan says the science will one day pay off, and that I will grow up to be incredibly beautiful.
Antihistamine.
Oh, luck of the draw. One moment, please. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E. Antihistamine, Mr. Panchy.
Don't pinch.
Well, I mean,
Miss Park.
Miss Park speaks 5 languages. No, I don't. Don't you? No. Well, it also says that you won your school's handwriting competition.
And does it also say that I only sleep 3 hours a night and I hide in my bathroom cabinet and I'm not allowed to cry?
No. No. No, it doesn't say that.
Well, it should. And it should say, I speak 6 languages.
Ah, 6.
Every language easy, easy as the recipe for making jello. I speak 6 languages, and I can say hello in at least 7 more.
It does say you're an athlete.
To excel in athletics is not difficult if one has the temperament. Apparently, I have the temperament. Ah! Yes, I score some goals. So in phase am I, as my life unscrolls. Unamazed am I don't like to brag. And I won't cause I don't have to, but I speak 6 languages. All American in hockey, and every time I stretch without getting sore. I speak 6 languages.
Okay, Moonstar Glory.
On behalf of Mrs. Strofsky. Just 1 minute, Logan.
Doesn't anyone here care about the rules? This spelling bee is so disorganized.
Does anyone mind if we get back to spelling?
I've been waiting for my word.
I gave you a word.
No, you didn't.
Didn't I give her a...
No.
My apologies. Sluice.
Sluice. Is that the definition of that word?
It's an artificial passage for water with a valve or gate for stopping and regulating flow.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Yes, a channel to drain or carry off surplus water.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Yes, it's a body of water pent up behind a floodgate.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Why would you get stolen and spell the damn word?
Principal Patch!
Vice Principal Patch! Vice Principal! They won't let me be principal!
Gee, I wonder why.
Sluice. S-L-U-I-C-E. Sluice.
That is correct. What is wrong with you? Michelle! Patch. Patch? Patch!
Yes?
It's time for a snack break.
Thank you, honey. I'll take it from here. Privacy, please!
Chris Logan, you're fine. Buck up. Ooh, that's no good.
No, let that dry. We have to disable the foot.
What foot?
Magic foot.
Don't be wrong.
Do you want to win?
Yes, but I do believe in ethical conduct.
Isn't having a magic foot an unfair advantage?
I don't have a magic foot!
Or a mother.
My dad's gonna come from work.
I would like to apologize for that incident. In my defense, I would like to point out that I am lactose intolerant. Miss Ostrovsky.
What did my dad say? Your dad says he's running late and will discuss the entrance fee with you when he gets here. But did you say what time he was gonna get here?
Chimerical.
What was the word?
Chimerical.
Can I have a definition?
It means unreal, imaginary, visionary, wildly fanciful, highly unrealistic.
I don't.
And you never asked me if I genuinely
Crepuscule.
Crepuscule. One moment, please.
Lilia! Lilia!
Shh!
C-R-E-P. Crep. U. S. Ew, there's something sticky. I'll take it from after the crep. U. S.
We need a spelling now.
Can I go wash my foot off first?
Now, Wilhelmina.
Can I have a definition?
It means twilight.
Twilight. Can you use it in a sentence?
She thought she was walking into the dawn, but it turned out it was the crepuscule.
Ew. Crepuscule. C-R-E-P. U? S-E-U-L-E. Crepuscule.
That is correct, Miss Schwartz and Grubinier.
Mom! I did it without the foot! I just like to say, Carlos Dabs, I can do this on my own.
Bug.
Bug? That's the whole word, bug?
Bug.
Bug. Language of origin?
Cornish dialect, a Latin derivative.
Cornish? That's like English with Dutch influence. Bug. B-U-G-G-H-E. Bug.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is B-U-G. Bug.
So simple.
So simple.
I'm so sorry, Dad. I overcomplicated.
I hope you still love me, America. America. I gave it my best try. If you still don't love me, triumphantly in this moment of
Perspective, your philosophy, the way you look at the world?
That is correct.
I know. You? It's okay, Barth. You and she. Elton Shawn.
We have a winner! We'd like to give you, Miss
Miss Wilhelmina Morris Barfay on this $200 savings bond towards her future education.
I've worked so hard for this moment. All my life, I've been able to breathe through one nostril, and today is no exception.
And this year, we're also offering a runner-up prize.
We are?
Yes, as you may know, if the winner cannot fulfill his or her duties as Spelling Bee County Champ, the runner-up must step in and fulfill all spelling responsibilities. So this year, our sponsors are offering a $25 cash prize for the second place finisher. Nice going, Ms. Ostrovsky.
Thank you. I can't believe it. Thank you. And Miss Freddy, I can pay the fee now.
Very good.
Very good. Very good.
Good thing. Oh, thanks, Ostrovsky. You too.
Well, I made a dumb mistake on the like lessons.
No, not sure. I wasn't sure how to spell that word either.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, no, I totally knew how to spell that word.
Hey, Barb.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Oh, of course. Oh. Foot five.
Aww. Woo-hoo! Vice Principal Pants found a new passion. Her name was Rona Lisa Burbank. After courting him tirelessly over 2 years, she took out her restraining order on him. Still, he was grateful for the opportunity to experience love.
Rona Lisa Peretti left Putnam County for a stretch to travel the world to bring spelling to the less fortunate. She traveled to Latvia, Sweden, and the Republic of Guinea-Bissau, where she fell in love with an indigenous cashew farmer and soon became the top realtor of that country.
Michelle Mahoney discovered a new talent at the Putnam Bee, so she continued her community service and made it lifelong, comforting frustrated educators and eliminated spellers across the nation. Over the years, she kept in touch with scores of people she'd comforted.
Oh, Chip Tolentino made it through adolescence and the course of time. Can't appreciate his erection, as did many others.
Marcy Park continued to explore the freedom of not living up to expectations. She later on went to write a book called Not Living Up to Expectations. It did not live up to expectations. She's very happy.
Leave Coney Bear. That's Katniss.
Psychiatry and podiatry, also known as. Where every year she interviewed the runner-up of the Putnam County Spelling Bee.
On the 25th anniversary.